and cool as Ickle Pickle, it's Ickle Mark Owen. Here he is. Mark.
Chris.
How are you?
I'm happy. Are you happy?
Yeah, I'm very happy. I'm very
happy. I'm happy because you're happy.
Oh, see? Hooray! Mark.
Yes.
What's best, to be 20% of Take That or to be 100% of Mark Owen? Oh, no, actually, no. What's more financially advantageous?
Okay.
Okay.
Take That.
Yeah. Honest.
Definitely, yeah.
No. Because you're all grown up now, aren't you? Because you've been... You've sort of gone out on your own. Your mum's like,
yeah,
out on your own.
Yeah, I've gone out. I've been allowed out. I've gone out and made my own album. I did it about a year ago now.
I know.
And it's been going well, but it's not at the same level at the moment, anyway, as what Take That was at. I mean, I was told the other day, got some great news for you, and I was told, you've recouped what you spent on your album. I thought, oh, yeah, we must be doing so well. And they said, yeah, you've recouped with all Take That money. So, I mean,
oh, no.
But I'm still earning more from Take That than what I'm doing.
Really?
Yeah.
So how do you still, if you don't mind me asking, how do you still get paid from Take That? Is it still royalties?
Well, it goes on for like a couple of years. Well, forever afterwards, really. I mean, money from Europe that you earn for selling albums and stuff kind of
So you get points on albums still?
Yeah, and it'll probably come through for forever, really, as long as Take That music is still going on. It gets put on like a... various albums, you know, in Europe, right. And stuff. You see, I always sit on MTV and Take That, and with, you know, like...
There was one on this morning at 10 to 9. Million Love Songs was on MTV, yeah. At 10 to 9. I was like, yes! I was, I really was. So for one album down, one solo album down,
yeah.
can you believe, I mean, because that was quite, that was not you, was it? You, I mean, you were on it, obviously, yeah. but I mean, that wasn't your bag. To go and do, that wasn't the deal in the beginning, you
no.
were just part of a band.
Exactly, I mean... I pretty much was for the full 6 or 7 years of Take That. I was just a part of a band. I never really thought I could do much on my own. And then,
were you scared?
Well, no. I mean, I always said that I'd be in Take That for as long as it lasted, and then when it ends, I'd just go quiet and do nothing. But when it did end, I just found myself... I mean, I love music, and I love being a part of it, and I like performing live and stuff like that, so I thought I'd have a go at making my own album.
And you did?
Yeah, I went into the record company and played on my first bunch of tapes. First bunch of songs, there's about 10 songs on there. And I played them the songs and I said, you know, listen to this, you know, like Paul Weller. You know, I could be like Paul Weller. And they're going, oh no, we see him always like, I don't know, Jason Donovan. Oh no, Paul Weller. No, Jason Donovan. But in the end, I think I just said it so many times that they thought, went, oh, stuff him, let him make the album he wants.
And it's done all right. I mean, it's gone platinum in Taiwan and all those kind of places.
No, it's done really well. It's gone gold in England, and and we're just, like I said, we're just going out on tour. It's done amazingly well. I think it's done about 800,000 albums and books, albums. I've got to be delighted. I've never written a song before. Did, yeah. I can't remember what it is.
You blimmin' well can. Go on.
No, I can't, honestly.
You can't remember that really important day in your life.
Honest to God, honestly. No, I wouldn't lower myself to that level anyway, but
When Kylie was on the show, we got Kylie.
At that point, I was like anything, you know. No, I just wanted to. I wanted to be a band. I wanted to be famous.
It's not a problem. It's not a problem at all.
I was told I was going to be in a band as big as the New Kids on the Block.
And you were.
And we were bigger, you know. We were bigger than them. We were better than them anyway. So. Yeah.
You know, the Spice Girls are now on the scene.
Yes.
Why don't you just reform and kick their ass?
I saw their. I mean, nothing against the Spice Girls and that.
Go on,
I saw their video on MTV.
Slag it off, go on. Yeah,
I saw their video on MTV again. I watch MTV Rock, sorry.
It's all right. Why don't you do what you like?
But I've watched their video and it's like Spice World or something. And then I turn off MTV and I've just got the telly on, and it is pretty much just like the video. I mean, every advert at the moment, they're popping up on. I mean, they're going through it big time.
Yeah, but see,
we never did that.
No,
we were always quite quiet. I mean, I don't know whether we never.
You weren't quite quiet, Mark.
No, we weren't.
I'm not letting you get away with that. You were huge.
I don't think we took advantage of.
Exactly.
That
Let's
was
talk about
that.
Yeah. This is much longer interview than we've ever had for, by the way, because it's very interesting.
Seriously,
I mean, do you, at the time, you must have thought you were, because you were on tour, you were doing all the right TV shows, you were selling millions of albums, you were even successful in America, which is very difficult to do, as some huge bands are finding at the moment. But did you realise then you were missing out on all the things? I mean, when the Spice Girls came along and they did the $7 million Pepsi promotion, you could have done all that.
Yeah, maybe we could. I mean, I think the Spice Girls, I mean, they broke America bigger than what we did.
Yeah.
They kind of broke the
But if you had your time
world.
Again, we'd take that. And I know it was great, and I know you just wanted the world.
Yeah, but we probably...
You could have...
I think we learned a lot from... They probably learned from us, and if we were coming round again as a new band, we'd probably say...
So you,
we could learn a lot from them
so
as well.
So you did all the groundwork, and they made all the money.
Yeah, we set it up for them.
Oh,
the five girls. The girls always do better anyway, don't they? They have a way of taking advantage of the guys.
Yeah, I know. So, look, you live in the Lake District, you're all chilled out, and you're into meditation. Is that right?
Kind of. I mean...
Or is that just some publicity bump? Because if it's bump,
it
we're talking about something... Okay.
No, it's not bump, actually.
How do you meditate? Give us a 30-second lesson.
I mean, I could do that all the time, but...
Did you meditate before the show tonight?
No, I should have done, shouldn't I? I would have been far better than this if I
had.
No, I'm only kidding, No, I was told before I came on to be confident, so... No, my band said to me before, I've been in rehearsals today with the band, and every time I go on telly, everybody always says it, that you're really humble and you kind of put yourself down, you know, you always say something positive and then go, well, actually...
But you're just being you, though. Don't change the way you are, for heaven's sake.
But they said,
no.
Be proud of yourself.
No, just be you, just be Mark Owen.
I agree, but, yeah, meditation is something...
Thinking about it.
It is something I did.
I'm going to change the subject.
No. Let me finish now. I've got it.
Okay, you got it.
It is something I did.
I love
in the
you.
Last... I love you. Are you happy?
I'm very happy. Yeah,
I'm happy.
A bit hot,
you're
though.
Happy.
Good. Go on.
No, I did it for about the last year of Take That, and then I went to an ashram for a week.
What's an ashram?
It's a place where you go, and you just meditate all day. And,
why did you feel at the age of 24, 25 to need to do that? I mean, that's a bit of a pop star
thing
to do.
It is, but it's something that I was really interested in. I was reading a lot about Buddhism, and I read things like the Book of Living and Dying, Tibetan Book of Living
Don't
and Dying.
Don't go potty on us.
No, I've been potty.
Because you're good for business.
No, I was potty. I went potty for about
a
year,
but
I've come back now. No, I didn't go potty. I just went flowery and, like, peace to the world.
All right, well, welcome back.
Thank you.
So listen, you've got 10 quid, right?
10 quid.
Which I hope it'll never happen, but you've got 10 quid,
yeah.
And you can only buy either Robbie's album or Gary's album? Which one do you buy?
Gary!
Robbie! Easy. Let him answer.
My answer would be, I hope I could keep the £10 in my pocket, and because I used to be in a band with them, they were giving me for free.
All right, I'll answer honestly. Go on.
More my kind of music is what Robbie's doing.
All right.
But, I mean, I understand.
Fair enough. No, you've answered the question. Not a lot of people would have done that. Well, look, it's lovely to have you on the show, and you've got to come back because I've got a million more questions.
Can we come on with my band and do a song for you?
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. What about New Year's Eve, Will? Seriously, what about New Year's Eve? We've got a New Year's Eve show. We're going to have a live New Year's Eve at 11 o'clock. Do you want to come on New Year's Eve?
I'd love to.
All right, deal. Yeah. All right, okay. And then can I ask you some more questions?
Yeah, then as well. Yeah.
All right, okay, Mark Owen, there he is, top man.
She heard a voice from so far away. Told her mother had gone away. In the next room, down the corridor, started to cry. Her whole life just fell apart. There was nothing. Then the hurting started in a heavy head. On her knees, I shed prayer. Yeah.